tomorrow, what do you say when I'm gone?
Somebody to someone, and if the sun starts setting, the sun chatter, but eventually less chat.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to the food in the canteen.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
I see myself as a very odd, strange person who still plays games even though I'm around 30 years old.
What's your favourite memory of primary school?
My favourite memory of primary school is probably meeting new people each year and getting to know about them and making friends.
What's the funniest memory you have?
My funniest memory was probably my first day of prep when I came to school with half of my hair in a plait and the other half in a bun.
What will you miss the most?
All of the easy work that we do because, no, I will miss all of the easy work that we do because in high school there'll be a lot of hard homework.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to making new friends and getting to do new subjects.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
I see myself in 20 years probably being an actress.
Hi.
What's your favourite memory of primary school?
When I ate soggy nutrient off the floor to make Hannah D become my friend.
What's your funniest memory?
When I had a dream that everyone in my family was dead and so I was frantically texting everyone to make sure that they were still alive.
What will you miss the most?
Probably the school, the people.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
The work will be a lot harder and challenging, so I'm looking forward to that because this sounds a lot of fun. Also, the subjects are very different.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
I see myself studying architecture. Well, because in 20 years I'll be 31. Probably settled down in a house with a bunch of cats. Being an architect, designing a bunch of stuff. Hopefully not alone. I don't want to be alone forever. That'd be sad. Yeah.
Thank you.
That was depressing.
Primary school.
My favorite memory of primary school was this year when I had my birthday and everybody got me presents. Mm-hmm.
What's the funniest memory?
I remember the funniest memory was probably when Will and Willow had a fake marriage.
What will you miss the most?
I will miss all of my friends and all of my teachers.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to making new friends and having lots of fun.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
In 20 years, I see myself working as a concreter.
Favorite memory of primary school?
My favorite memory is probably the last day of grade 5.
What is your funniest memory?
My funniest memory is when there was like a huge bee tornado and everyone was screaming and running.
What will you miss most?
What I will miss most is probably my friends and the easy work.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to a lot more opportunities and to be able to make new friends.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
Hopefully continuing to play tennis, maybe even professional tennis, and be acting.
Favourite memory of primary school?
My favourite memory of primary school is when we went to camp in year 4.
What is your funniest memory?
Pass.
What will you miss most?
I will miss the basketball courts and some of my friends as well.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
To make a lot of new friends.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
An NBA player. In 20 years, I will be an NBA player.
Primary school.
My favourite memory is probably when I first came to prep and I met Hannah and Kayla.
What's your funniest memory?
When we were doing the Year 6 weird paintings on timber wood and Marty ruined his eyebrows.
What will you miss the most?
I'll probably miss my friends in the library.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I think I'm looking forward to exploring a new campus.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
In 20 years, I see myself as an architect.
Favorite memory of primary school?
I think at camp in year 4 or year 3, I can't really remember. But there was this like rafting competition that we won, and like a sandcastle building competition as well, and that was really fun. Because I just remember everyone kind of picked up a role and just stuck to it. Like there was kids telling other kids, oh, do this, you know, can you do that? Can you get that for me? And those kids who like had the jobs, and it felt like you were really involved. I don't know, yeah.
What's your funniest memory?
Definitely either, yeah, Alexi in a tutu made of pink plastic.
What will you miss the most?
I think I guess my sorry I guess being able to annoy my brother constantly because he's in year 3, so
yeah. What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to, having, I guess, more opportunities and, like, things to do than in primary school.
Why do you see yourself in 20 years?
Dead. No, I know. I guess I'd like to write screenplays. I think that would be really cool. Or I just really like the idea of working in writing and in the movie industry or the TV industry or whatever you want to call it. But yeah.
What's your favourite memory of primary school?
My favourite memory would be my friends coming to my house.
What's your funniest memory?
Probably when we did Try Not to Laugh and Isaac was trying to make us laugh.
What will you miss the most?
Probably the school, the teachers, the kids in it as well.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to making new friends and meeting new teachers. Just learning more.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
Probably teaching.
What are your primary school?
My favorite memory of primary school is meeting everybody at school and being lucky to see everybody in FaceTime.
What's your funniest memory?
My funniest memory is moving in a school test time.
What will you miss most?
That I miss most is seeing some of my friends.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to learn better there.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
I see myself working.
What's your favorite memory of primary school?
Whenever I'm alone, I always have some friends, and that made me happy. That's the favorite memory.
What's your funniest memory?
Funniest memory is fake weddings.
What will you miss the most? What are you looking forward to in high school?
To seeing my friend Annie again.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
I will see myself as like a hard-working artist.
Hi families, thank you for coming along. So we're going to start in a few minutes. So what's going to happen is all the grade sixes, they're just in the hallway on the first floor, and they're actually going to walk down in roll order, and we're going to ask you to stand in two lines, and they'll walk down, wave, and and then they'll get straight into their positions. So I'll give you a few more minutes just to keep all your stuff, put all your stuff down and everything, and then we'll go over there in a minute or two.
First. Favorite memory of primary school?
My favorite memory is, I think, seeing my friends like every day.
What's your funniest memory?
My funniest memory, I'd say, is just the weird conversations I have.
What will you miss most?
I guess seeing everyone.
What are you looking forward to in high school?
I'm looking forward to meeting new people.
Where do you see yourself in 20 years?
In 20 years, I see myself making clothes, making and designing clothes.
What's your favourite memory of primary school?
My favourite memory is probably making an art project with Hazel on the last week.
What's your funniest memory?
My funniest memory is, can't remember any.
What will you miss most?
Okay, looks like they're nearly ready. So what we're going to ask you to do is just leave your belongings where they are, because you'll come back to the same seats. And we're going to make two lines just over there, if we can move there now. And the U6s will be ready in just a few moments. Thanks. Oh, what was some of the ones we were playing earlier?
Is
they were good.
Through this?
Hey?
On your screen there, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, I might use your iPad then.
Maybe it's your friend. Brad, I know it's late notice, but don't worry if you can't. Are you able to put any music on now, or we have to control all that?
Just in the background
screen. Oh, no. That's all right. We can just play it through there.
That teacher had...
Yeah, that's all right. Dane can do it. Yeah, just anything. Oh, that's like the starting. Yeah. We're just waiting for some music. Hello. All right, first up, we have Ariana Burns. Come down, Ari. Yeah, go. Give her a clap. Next, we have Marty Hardy. Lachlan Hall. Scala Hoy.
Get some music.
India Johnson. Annika Maguire. Alia Patterson. Oh, we've got the music now as well. Excellent, here we go. Marie Tran, or her nickname, Kai.
Pump up the jam, pump it up.
From Sixth, Isaac McGuinness. Can we give the graduating class of 6A another round of applause, please?
And for 6B, we have Muhammad Adam. We also have Aaron Baxter. Next up, we have Eleanor Burton. Come on down, Hazel Jinx. Alice Johnson Lee. Come on down. Adriana Robert Graham. And Pranesh Thapa. Come on down, Pranesh.
Pump it up a little more. Get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at. And you find out if you do that. Oh, wow. A place to stay.
Get Let's your go, Pranesh. All right, next we have 560. This is Aiden Clark, everyone. And next we have Hannah Danielis. Go, Hannah. Next we have Millie Diebel. Come on down, Millie. Next we have Layla Kilby. Everyone give a big cheer for Hannah Rudwin. And another big cheer for Josh Romeo. And finally for 560, Ethan Fitz. Let's give the last few a really big cheer. Thank you so much, parents. We're going to make our way back to our chair to get started with the ceremony.
Yeah.
Once upon a time, there were a group of children who started prep at Coburg Primary School. They were then joined by others in grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4, grade 5, and grade 6. There are many stories shared by this group of students from all across these years. Then there was 2020 and 2021, when things got a bit strange. You're all on mute. And then there are some stories that may or may have not happened during this time. And so now this legendary bunch of grade 6 Coburg Primary School students prepare to embark on their high school years. I wonder what they think about that. I'm excited about going to high school. I'm excited about going to high school. I can imagine just what my first day of high school will be like. I can imagine what my first day of high school will be like. I think I'm a lot like my parents. I think I'm a lot like my parents. I'm a creative person. I'm a creative person. I'm an athletic person. I'm an athletic person. I am brave. I am brave. I want to travel to many places. I want to travel to many places. I'm good at keeping secrets. I'm good at keeping secrets. I think being an adult will be easy. I think being an adult will be easy. I know what I want to be when I grow up. I know what I want to be when I grow up.
Streisand.
We hope you enjoy remembering our primary school days with us and are imagining into what the future holds. Thank you, parents, for everything you do for us. Thank you, teachers, and the time you care you've taken to help us. Now watch us grow wings as we fly into the next chapter of our lives, high school.
Thank you and good evening, everyone. I am India. This is Isaac, Millie and Hannah, and we would like to formally welcome you to the Year 6 graduation ceremony of 2021. We hope you enjoy this ceremony. We would first like to give a massive thank you to Sarah Austin, Isaac's mum, who has volunteered her time to create the Year 6 performance you have just witnessed. We appreciate how you took all of our ideas and helped us produce this. And thank you from the school captains and grade sixes. We would like to give you this. Can we please give a round of applause for Sarah?
As you all know, 2021 has been a roller coaster of a year, and we have faced many challenges, especially as Year 6 transitioning into high school. This year has truly tested our resilience, but we have developed skills over the last few years to tackle anything that is in our way.
All of us have thoroughly enjoyed planning and practicing the ceremony. We've worked hard and persevered through the frequently changing restrictions to hopefully deliver to you a very memorable evening.
Well, with all of this said, it's very important that we all follow the COVID-19 guidelines so we can all have an exciting but safe evening. We thank you for being flexible in our accommodating the changes of restrictions. We would now like to invite Jacob Cantor, our school council president, to say a few words.
Firstly, thank you everybody for coming here tonight. It's a wonderful, wonderful occasion. I'm just glad that we can all be here in person rather than on the videos. Now, to all of the children, the graduates of this year, 2021, congratulations. Thank you very much for making it a very, very memorable evening. You've just been wonderful. And one of the words that was used today was brave. I am brave. Now, notwithstanding all of the values that you've picked up through the years at this school, I would implore you all to think of that word. Be brave. Be brave as people. Be brave into the future. It will hold you in good stead. So congratulations on your graduation. And on behalf of the school council, we wish you all the best for the next 6 years. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jacob. We would now like to welcome Matt, our principal, to come and say a few words.
Matt.
That is 2021 in one image there. Okay. Yeah, should have taken a photo of that, Jane. Okay, good afternoon everyone. As acting principal of Coburg Primary School, I proudly stand before you to officially welcome you to our 2021 Year 6 graduation. And as Jacob said, what a year it has been. And I am so pleased, you don't understand, I am so pleased to be able to hold this event, have it outdoors, have good weather, COVID free. I am so, so happy, but most importantly, I'm so happy that it's face to face. So thank you everyone for joining us. Now, firstly, I want to say we are so incredibly proud of these young people who sit in front of us today. You are the reason why the teachers and all of the staff, you are the reason why we come to school every day. I hope the primary school has given you many fond memories, which you'll take with you forever. You've dealt with many challenges throughout your time at primary school, and the past 2 years have tested your resilience, and they tested the resilience of everyone. And I want to thank you for the way you have managed these challenges, continued to show empathy, kindness, and care. It's important to celebrate these milestones, and today's celebration would not be possible without the hard work and detailed planning by so many. I'd like to thank the dedicated team of teachers, headed up by Alexi, Tamara, Jacob, our specialist teachers, Nib, Dane, Aaron, and our office staff who have helped make tonight possible. Now, I'd like to give them a big clap. I know for a fact that Alexi has not slept for 3 weeks. Alexi was up at 3 a.m. this morning, he was saying, but we have made it. Well done to those just. Okay, I'd like to also acknowledge our families. Thank you for choosing this school. Thank you for putting your trust in us to teach your kids and to help them grow as a child. I'd also like to acknowledge the following families who will be parting ways from the school. Rayanne's family, Muhammad's family, Aaron Baxter's family, Ari's family, Aidan Clark's family, Millie's family, Marty's family, Scarla's family, Hazel's family, Layla's family, Alia's family, Pranesh's family, Ethan's family, and the Tran family. Thank you to those families. Thank you for your support and for being a part of this amazing, vibrant school community. Many of you have made significant contributions to the school over the years, and we wish you all the very best. Let's give a round of applause for the families. I overheard something before, and it was Jolly talking to Selena, and they were saying that out of the 25 graduating students, 16 of those students began with us as preps. And that core group has stayed together. And then as we saw from the performance, we've had many additions along the way. Now, to think about these kids as little preppies on the junior school with Jolly Laris and Sam Basaggio in 2015 to now. When I think about this group as a whole, there are some key qualities that come to mind. Kindness, empathy, an awareness of self, and a strong sense of justice. Now, I was thinking about this and I was talking with Lucy today, and I wanted to talk about some things that you would see if you came out into our yard at lunchtime. And I spoke with some of the students, and these are some of the things that you would see on the daily from these students. You would see an arm wrapped around another child's back who's having a bad day. You'd see a group of students sitting in a circle having a mature conversation. That conversation may even be around world politics. You would see Josh and Aidan Clark talking all things footy and sport. That has not changed. And I saw this also today. You'd see a year six child helping any of our little children head into sick bay. The students here are welcoming and they care for each other. I did ask Lily Kimpton-Drake this morning what else you would see in the yard, and I'm not sure about this one. Lily said to me this morning, I said, Lily, what would you see in the yard if you looked out in the yard? And she said, groups of kids running away from the teachers because they don't have hats on. I don't know about that one, but I thought I would include that. I have seen that recently. All right. Now, I know when principals do these speeches, they use quotes from people that you may never have heard of. I don't want to do that. I want to talk about a little story which is a bit closer to home. And it's over on the left-hand side. You won't be able to see it, but I'll talk to you about it. 12 months ago, we noticed a white pigeon sitting on top of the roof overlooking the school. This pigeon, each day, would overlook our chicken shed on the left. Each day, the pigeon would gradually get closer and closer to our chicken house. After many days of the pigeon hanging around near the chicken house, it became apparent that the pigeon wanted to be with the chickens. Initially, I thought the pigeon just wanted some food scraps, but I was wrong. The pigeon, which the kids have named Peppy the Pigeon, had actually decided that he wanted to live life as a chicken. Each night when Agostino, our maintenance man, would close the chicken door, Peppy the Pigeon would fly through the door to be in with the chickens. After months and months, can I please have the chicken photo? Oh, it is up. After months and months, Peppy now lives with the chickens. He walks like a chicken. He sits on the perch with the chickens, as you can see in the photo. And he is now embraced by the chickens as one of them. Now, you might think that I have completely lost it with this, but I actually think we can learn a lot from Peppy. And if Coburg Primary School has taught you anything, I want you to remember this. Be whoever you want to be. Do whatever you want to do. Find your passion, work hard, do it well, and be kind. Be like Peppy. Step forward. Put yourself into wobbly ground. Put your hand up. It doesn't matter what anyone else thinks. Be like Peppy. Thank you.
Thank you, Matt, for your kind words. Now Alexi will say a few words and then introduce his graduating students of 2021. Each student will also share a poem that they have written titled I Am. If you would like to give a round of applause at at the end of each poem, please do.
Thank you, Hannah. I'm just going to say a few words on behalf of us teachers, and it was just interesting listening to Matt speak, that we're actually thanking a lot of the same people. Firstly, by popular demand, we have Brad, our audio guy, in the van. He can hear us, so can we give him a big round of applause? Go, Brad. He's doing everything behind the scenes. I think we might have to make this a tradition. And Matt has actually been name-dropping him for 2 years now. And apparently, Brad is off to film an international artist after graduation tonight. And Matt's been angling for an invite all day. I don't think he's got it yet. Thanks, Brad, for everything tonight. Wow, what a year. It was touch and go for a while, but we made it. It's just so great that we can share this evening in person rather than WebEx. I think that's one program we would like to see the back of. To think we have now gone through 2 years of COVID and home learning. There's a saying, it takes a community to raise a child. We're all lucky to be part of the Coburg Primary School community. Matt and Lucy and Jane before have created such a positive and resilient school environment. They instill confidence in all of us teachers, and we truly are very lucky to have such supportive, understanding and collaborative leaders. When we were brought back into lockdown, we always felt that we were one step ahead, not one step behind. We were ready for any upcoming challenge. You do so much for the teachers, aides and students, and we all appreciate you. Assemblies do get a little bit weird at times, but hey, you can't have everything, right? Can we give them a round of applause, please? Next, some of our unsung heroes. So thank you to everyone that's putting this day together. So Paula and Diane in the office, who bound all of these booklets that took a while, I know. Joy for making sure we never go over budget, ever. The aides, I can see Kim and Tiz over there, and some of these aides have been with these students for many, many years and have seen them grown up from prep to year six. So obviously this day is really special to see them graduating. And Aga, Mr. Fix-It. Also, we have some former teachers who have made it too. So we've got Noah and Alyssa down the back. So they've all come to see, yeah, some of the students are like, wow, yeah, that's right, Marty. So what is great about Coburg Primary School is it genuinely feels like a community and everyone does their part, whatever it is, to make it what it is. Now for some of the real heroes over the last 2 years, it's been all of you, parents and families. The sacrifices you have had to make at home to support your child's education, the tears, the nagging, all those extra things that you've had to endure, it's been appreciated. You've had to do so much more than what you should have to, put on so many extra hats, but without you, it wouldn't have worked. So can we give a round of applause to yourselves? Lastly, the students. So students, I want you to look out into the audience. All the faces you see are immensely proud of you and are here to celebrate who you are today and all of your achievements. You have got through 2 years of remote learning, have overcome every obstacle that has stood in your way, and we have no doubt you are ready to tackle any challenge that high school throws up. You are ready for the next step in your journey, and as everyone at Coburg Primary becomes a memory, you know we will always be there rooting for your every success in your life ahead. Can we give the students a round of applause? Okay, now I will read out the names of all the graduating students in 6A. They will come up, read a stanza of their I Am poem, and then receive their graduation package. First up, we have Ariana Burns.
It's poem time. I'm colourful and bright. I wonder what my future will hold for who I am now and who I might become. I hear the sound of the school bell ringing, and it brings me right back to when I heard it for the very first time. I see the school that is no longer so big and scary, but a second home. I want every child who follows after me to learn and feel happy like I did. I'm colourful and bright.
Thank you, Ari. Okay, so we'll use the steps. Okay, next up we have Marty.
I am funny and sporty. I wonder if I'll ever be in the NBA. I hear people cheering me on as I play basketball. I see crowds waiting to see me play. I want to be an NBA player. I am funny and sporty.
Thank you, Marty. Next, we have Lachlan Hall.
I am unique and curious. I wonder what high school will be like. I hear the chattering of the kids in the playground. I see the playground packed with kids. I want to find out what high school is like. I'm unique and curious.
Thank you, Lachlan. Next, we have Scala Hoy.
I am creative and confident. I wonder how snakes procreate. I hear nature. I see a castle. I want to be brave. I am creative and confident.
Thank you, Scala. Next, we have India Johnson.
I am creative and determined. I wonder if I'll be the same in 10 years. I hear kids laughing as they run across the playground. I see the stairs, knowing this will be one of the last times I go down them. I want high school to be just as great as primary. I'm creative and determined.
Next, we have Annika Maguire.
I am fidgety and unique. I wonder if I'll become a fashion designer. I hear the chickens and it makes me think of Chicken Judy in year two. I see hats and think of my first one being too big. I want to always remember my primary school friends. I'm fidgety and unique.
Get you, Annika. Thank you, Annika. Next we have Alia Patterson.
I'm athletic and focused, ready to face on the world. I wonder what I'll be like in the present. Will my dreams come true? I hear kids talking, playing and laughing. I see a dream that I'm going to need to face my last goodbye. I want high school to be a better change. I'm athletic and focused and ready to face on the world.
Thank you, Alia. Next, we have Marie Tran, or her nickname, Kai. Next, we have Isaac McGuinness.
Hi, all! I am unique and interesting. I wonder who I may be in 5 years. I hear the sounds of group of laughing stock kids that are in years below me, and it brings back memories. I see myself throughout the years. I want to be able to know what will happen in the future. I am unique and interesting.
Isaac. Can we give another round of applause to the graduating class of 6A?
Thank you, Alexi. We're now going to present to you the Year 6 dance that we have been working on for the past few weeks. Once everyone is quiet and in position, we will begin. The song we will be performing is There's Nothing Holding Me Back. Thank you, Aaron, for organising this with us.
About her and she knows it. I wanna let it take control, 'cause every time that she gets closer, she pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. And maybe I should stop and start confessing. Confessing, yeah. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation. Manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. Says that she's never afraid. Just picture everybody naked. She really doesn't like to wait. Not really into hesitation. Pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. Oh, and maybe I should stop and start confessing. Shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation. Manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. Took it way too far. I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. When we stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright. 'Cause if we lost our minds and we took it way too far, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. We stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation. Manipulate my decisions.
Thank you, Aaron, for your amazing efforts. We hope you all enjoyed the dance. We now have Jacob presenting the graduating students in 6B. Thank you, Jacob.
Okay, for the graduating class of 6B, first up we have Rayan Abdullahi.
I'm tall and gentle. I wonder what is high school will be like. I hear people calling me. I see my mom. I want to go to Egypt. I'm tall and gentle.
Muhammad Adam.
I am athletic and funny. I wonder if I can be a goalkeeper for Australia. I hear the fans screaming my name. I see my team celebrating. I want to play for Manchester United. I am athletic and funny.
Aaron Baxter.
I'm kind and caring. I want it will be like going to high school. I see myself helping others. I want to make new friends next year. I'm kind and caring.
Eleanor Burton.
I am loyal and friendly. I wonder why we have to do a graduation dance. I hear math problems flying through my head, longing to be solved. I see myself walking to high school on my first day. I want to make new friends at high school. I'm loyal and friendly.
Hazel Jinx.
I am creative and kind. I wonder what the future holds. I hear waves crashing. I see high school. I want unlimited books. I am creative and kind.
Alice Johnson Lee.
I am quiet and curious. I wonder what the world will be like in the future. I hear waves splashing against the sand. I see tall trees swaying in the breeze. I want the world to be happy. I am quiet and curious. Yes.
And Adriana Robert Graham.
I am hopeful and curious. I wonder what it's like to be a parent. I hear what they say about me. I see new opportunities. I want friends that will stay with me until it is. I'm hopeful and curious.
And lastly, we have Pranesh Thapa.
I'm Pranesh, I'm sporty and curious. I wonder how high school is going to be. I hear people's footsteps. I see my uncle extra base. I want to go on the top of the hill. I'm sporty and curious.
Can we have another round of applause for the graduating class of 6B?
Thank you, Jacob. Now the Year 6s will perform the Year 6 song that we have been working on. Sorry, parents, if we have been singing a little bit too much at home, but it was all for a good cause.
You were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. And my heart felt like December when somebody say your name, cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright. Go raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything. Memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. Time that I remember when I never felt so lost, when I felt that all the hatred was too powerful to stop. And my heart felt like an ember and it's lighting up the dark. I could have these torches for ya, that you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright. Go raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back all the memories. Memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. Yeah 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 yeah. Memories bring back you.
Testing.
Don't you damn.
I was testing it.
No, you're good.
Okay.
Everybody.
Oh, I'm going to be up here in front of everyone soon.
Thank you, Dane, for leading and preparing the music performance. Well done to all the grade 6 students. Next, we have Tamara presenting the graduating students from 6C.
Thank you. It's an absolute pleasure to introduce 6C for you tonight. First up, we have Lamar Asiri.
I'm lovely and happy. I wonder about high school. I hear music. I see my friend. I want be an artisan. I want to be unhappy.
Next, we have Aiden Clark.
I'm curious and sporty. I wonder what high school would be like. I hear kids rushing down the stairs for lunchtime. I see myself walking down the stairs for the last time. I want a deep, rich chocolate milkshake. I'm curious and sporty.
Next, we have Hannah Danielis.
I am kind and supportive. I wonder what happens when you die, so, you know, dark note. I hear the cheering and encouragement of inter-school sports. I see the colour-filled trees with their swaying branches. I want to make a difference. I am kind and supportive.
Next, we have Millie Deeble.
Hello. I am responsible and trustworthy. I wonder what my life will be like in the future. I hear the whisper of the stories entrancing me. I see the pages of the old books asking me to read them. I want to go back to when I didn't have to decide things. I'm responsible and trustworthy.
Next we have Layla Kilby.
I am funny and kind. I wonder about the world and how it was made. I hear kids laughing in the schoolyard. I see kids playing. I want to learn how to surf. I am funny and kind.
Next we have Hannah Rudwin.
I am honest and resilient. I wonder what will happen to the school when I'm older. I hear the voices of children laughing at recess and lunch. I see my friends growing older beside me. I want to be a surgeon when I'm older. I am honest and resilient.
Next we have Joshua Romeo.
I am sporty and supportive. I wonder what job I'll get when I'm older. I hear sounds of laughter. I see my friends playing soccer. I want to be proud of my work in high school. I am sporty and supportive.
And finally, we have Ethan Thicke.
I'm artistic and nice. I wonder what happens after people die. I hear younger kids laugh and play around. I see my old self running around the school. I mean, younger self, without a care in the world. I want to get my dream job of becoming an artist. I'm artistic and nice.
And let's have one more round of applause for 6C, please.
Now, just before we announce the awards, we have a special guest who will be saying a few awards.
I wonder who it is. Jane.
You're the special guest. I thought it might have been me. Well, welcome everyone. It's lovely to be here tonight and to be here for this very, very special occasion. Your final, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you will know what you know. And you are the one who'll decide where to go. So be sure when you step with care and great tact. And remember,
Can I please call Lexi to present the Val Awards?
Values.
Thank you, Isaac. So this award goes to someone that shows all of the school values. I'm not going to list them all because I always forget one. Someone that shows all the school values. I just want to start with a little story about this student that might give you a bit of an idea of what they're like. So one morning, she was really worrying about getting the vaccine. And she was complaining, she was worrying, like, oh, I'm going to get this. And then we were, for reading, we were looking at these Afghani refugees that had resettled into Australia. Oh, sorry, these orphans that had resettled into Australia recently. And it had some of their quotes about how they're just really happy to have an education. And some of the girls were saying their future now is bright because they have an education. And this student said afterwards, she said, you know what, how am I complaining about something like this when people are going through that? And she said that her parents were going to give her a little reward, a little monetary reward for getting the vaccine. She said, you know what, I'm just going to give it to the orphans. So even though she starts showing all the school values, two of her strongest qualities is empathy and kindness, and she's going to make a big difference in the world. So this award goes to Ariana Burns.
Can I please call Tamara to present the Excellence Award?
So the student receiving this award has excelled in all areas of our school life. They are a true all-round superstar, working hard within their own learning to succeed, but also taking care to always be fair and generous to others. Their strong sense of community has been appreciated by so many at Coburg Primary School. It is an honour to present the Excellence Award to Hannah Danielis.
I would now like to invite our presenter from the Coburg Rotary Club, who will present the awards for respect and responsibility.
Rotary Club?
Where are you? Excuse me. The Coburg Rotary Club Award. I don't know.
Respect and resilience. No, that's okay, you have to say.
I don't know.
Are they giving money? Are they giving money out?
One second.
It's been a while, you know. This is an award for responsibility, and it goes to Hannah Radwan.
Oh, that's me. That's me.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Thank you. Look, can I just add that we've there's a voucher in there, there's a letter in there, so read it. It's from on behalf of the Rotary Club of Coburg. It's about your future, and look, the next award is for respect, and it goes to Alia Patterson. Sit on, Alia.
I would like to invite Heather Harris from the Pasco Vale Rotary Club, who will present the awards for learning and resilience.
Thank you so much. And it is a great pleasure to be here and representing Pasco Vale Rotary. And we're giving two awards this evening. And the first one is the Pasco Vale Rotary Learning Award, and it goes to Adriana Robert Graham. Well done. Our second award is the Resilience Award, and that goes to Lachlan Hall. There you go. Congratulations to all of you, and when I look at these wonderful young people and what's ahead for, you know, them, it's just so exciting, and I feel very privileged to be able to do this. So well done, everybody. Thank you.
I would now like to invite Sergeant Rob from Moreland Police, who will present the Moreland Police Community Award.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone. Senior Sergeant Rob from Faulkner couldn't be here tonight, but I'm Shane Manuel from Brunswick Police Station, so it's a real pleasure. We work hand in hand with Faulkner, so it's great to be here tonight. Thank you for the invitation. I'd just like to thank Rotary. Victoria Police work hand in hand with Rotary in relation to this award. And the award that I'm presenting tonight is the Moreland Police Community Award. And this award goes to someone who's been exhibiting the community values and also the school values. So I'd like to congratulate Eleanor Burton.
Congratulations.
For you.
Get a stick for you. Well.
So well done. Okay. Again, thank you everybody. Reiterating the words of Rotary, our future leaders here. You do yourself proud, you do the community proud, and you do the school proud. So well done. Thank you.
Oh. Could we please have a round of applause for the Coburg and Pasco Vale Rotary Clubs and the Moreland Police, who have supported our graduation and kindly donated these awards. Let's also give all of the students who received an additional award another round of applause to acknowledge their achievements.
Can I please ask all the students to now stand and face the audience? We would like to formally present the Year 6 class of Coburg Primary School for 2021. Thank you. You may now sit down.
For our final word from Millie, I would like to let our families know that there will be a photo opportunities at the conclusion of our ceremony. Students, please take your belongings to your families at the end of the ceremony. Finally, we would like to acknowledge and thank Nib for her creative support with the Year 6 portraits, Dane for organising our Year 6 song, and Aaron for planning and leading the dance. Thank you to all the teachers, aides who have taught us along the years, and the office administration staff and AGA. I can't read it, Millie. For ensuring our school grounds are kept well. And Matt, Jane and Lucy, and our parents, guardians and families for the endless love and support you give.
Thank you, India. I and my fellow school captains for 2021, Isaac, Hannah and India, and our classmates, would like to formally thank you all for coming to this evening and sharing in this special occasion with us all. The impact that you have all had on our lives is special, and we are who we are because of your example, teachings, love and support. Family and friendship are what makes life special. It is all of you sitting in front of us that creates the memories we have not only of our primary school years, but our lives to date. These memories, I'm sure, we all will bring into the next chapter of our lives as we continue to change, develop, and grow as individuals. Before our final performance, I would like to end the formalities with a special quote. Memento mori. This translates to, remember you will die. And as a reminder to take risks and live life to the fullest. So it's not bad. It's nice.
Is this, okay, it's working. Testing, okay, it works. Thank you very much, everyone. That'll be all for tonight.
And yeah, you can get photos and mingle. So. Well, not too close, obviously.
Thank you, Dan.
Thanks.